In this session, we are going to understand the overview of software development process. So we are going to look at it in three steps. First, we will be looking at the nature of software and the software industry. So then we will be looking at some challenges we are facing. And finally, we will look at the approaches in overcoming those challenges. So let's look at the nature of software and the software industry. So here we are going to look at some key features of software and software industry. The conceptual nature, the development of unique product, and also the possibility of providing it as a service. So unlike many other industries, in software development, we are producing a conceptual product. So conceptual product means a product which is not physical tangible. If you take some other areas like car manufacturing of any other machinery. So we are into the physical tangible products. We call that we are manufacturing, but we don't manufacture software. We just produce software once, and then we can let many users use it, or we are moving to another development. There are some pros and cons due to this conceptual nature of the product. So let's look at some of those. So one of the challenges that we face is the ambiguity in understanding the requirements. Because it's a conceptual product, it's very difficult to explain. And also, when you are developing the software, it's difficult to measure the progress. And there are some positive things as well. Since software is the conceptual, there's a high possibility of reusability. And when it comes to reusability, there are some other concerns like the intellectual property related, like copyrights. And also, unlike physical products, the software is easy to change because of the conceptual nature. And also, it's easy to develop software using virtual teams because we are not working on a physical product. So the team members can be in different part of the world and still they can contribute to the development of the software. So the second feature is we are developing a unique product. So why we are developing a unique product? Because no point developing the same product twice. That is why we say this is not manufacturing. Because we can easily copy and give it to any number of customers if it is a general product. So therefore, whenever we involve in developing a software, we are involved in developing a new software or considerably modified version of a previous software. So therefore, this is more challenging. And also, there's a high risk involved because we are developing a new product all the time. When you are developing new things, we have to do excessive testing. It is not testing a manufactured item. This is a new product. So that is why there's a lot of emphasis on quality assurance in software industry. So the third aspect is there's a possibility of providing software as a service. So we traditionally develop software as a product and give it to the customer. So we package them and we give it to the customer or we deploy them on their machines. But the new trend is because of this conceptual nature, we can provide the software as a service as well. So rather than providing the software as a product, we can have the software with us and we can let the users use it. And that means we are providing it as a service. So there are again pros and cons. So we have the better control and it's easier for us to update. And also this is very effective way of countering the software piracy because we are not giving the software or the code. But there are some concerns about security and privacy as well because the customer loses sort of a control over the software. Now let's move into the challenges that we faced in developing software. So we are going to look at few important points. The complexity, the need of doing multitude of tasks, the project nature, the high business demand, and the nature of evolving field. So let's take one by one. So developing software is a complex task. So it involves a lot of technical and other complexities. And also we need to integrate with different systems in most of the cases. When it comes to developing software, there are multitude of tasks that we have to perform. So we have to understand the requirement by analyzing it. We have to design the solution. So then there are various aspects of development, from UI development to the developing the business flows, the setting up of the databases, and of course the quality assurance and the management of the project. The third challenge is the project nature of software development. So project means we have a definite starting point and ending point with deliverables. And we have to deliver it within expected time frame, expected budget, and we have to deliver the agreed functionalities with expected quality as well. And finally, there's a very high business demand as well. Because the business organizations heavily depends on software for almost all their functionalities. So they depends on information systems for their day-to-day operations, the transaction processing systems. So they depends on the information systems for better business intelligence, the data mining, online analytical processing, etc. And also their management is heavily depends on different management information systems and decision support systems for their decision making. So therefore a lot of expectation is there, and also businesses are in a very dynamic competition. So therefore when we are developing software, that pressure is partly transformed to the software development team. They need the software in no time with highest quality. And finally, the software development field is an evolving field. It's a new field. So we are working with evolving technologies, evolving software development processes, because software development or the commercial software development started somewhere around 1970s. So that means we have only about 50 years of industry. So when we are working with evolving technologies, evolving processes, there's always high risk. Now let's look at how to overcome those challenges and develop software in a successful manner. So the software industry has come up with different techniques and procedures to counter those challenges. In order to overcome the technical challenges or the technical complexities, we are using the engineering approach. So that is why we call it software engineering. And when it comes to handle the complexity of or challenges of project nature, we have the project management. That is why we have project managers when it comes to software development team. And in order to face the business demands, we use the agile approach. So the engineering approach, the project management, and agile practices, we use these three combination to counter the challenges and develop software in a successful manner. So let's take one by one. Whenever there's a technical complexity, there is engineering. And of course, there's a technical complexity when it comes to developing software, and that is why we have the software engineering field. So the engineering field has some common practices and processes. So let's see what is the common approach in engineering. So engineers are designing and developing new things. So in engineering, first we investigate and check the feasibility. So then we analyze to understand the requirements in detail. So then we come up with a design of the solution. Then only we develop it, test it, and then we moved on to the maintenance In some engineering disciplines, in between the testing and maintenance, we have the deployment as well. For example, if it is a power plant, yes, there will be a deployment part. But if it is manufacturing of a vehicle, so there's no deployment part. In software engineering, again, we have the deployment part in most of the projects. So the second technique that we use to overcome the complexities or challenges due to the project nature is we apply the project management techniques. So project management is a special branch in management. So we have the general management, so they manage the day-to-day activities, whereas project managers manage the projects. So what are the key aspects in project management? So the project management is all about managing the time, managing the cost, managing the quality, and managing the scope. And there are some other areas as well, like the risk management, human resource management, communication management, and so on. But these are the four main aspects. And also when it comes to management, we all know that the key tasks in management are planning, organizing, leading, and controlling. So when we apply the management practice to the project, and especially concerning about this time, cost, scope, and quality, we call it the project management. And finally, in order to tackle the business demands, we adopt the agile development approaches or agile practices. So the agile approach is based on two things: the agile values or philosophy and agile process. So let's look at what are the key values in agile. So why do we need agile approach? Because the businesses are highly dynamic, highly competitive. So in a dynamic environment, we need to be agile. We need to be flexible. Otherwise, we can't survive. So what are the key agile values? The simplicity, leanness, customer-oriented decision-making, openness, and sustainable pace. So they are highly interrelated. So if you want to develop something fast, and also there's a possibility of future changes to that product, so the one of the important aspect is make it simple. And also when we want to develop something fast, we have to make sure that we focus only on absolute essential tasks only. We don't want to waste our time. That is what leanness is all about. Ultimately, our product is going to be used by the customer. So our focus is during the development. It is the customer that is going to use it for the long term. So therefore, we have to look at it from the customer's point of view when it comes to some important decisions. And also, it's very important that we keep very open environment within the team as well as with the customer. Software development is not an easy task. It's a complex task. It's a complicated task. It's a stressful task at time. So that is why we want to maintain a sustainable pace throughout the development. And those are the key values in agile development. And the software engineers have come up with a process and some variations of that process as well. So we call them different agile processes. So right now the most popular is the Scrum-based development. Earlier we heavily used the extreme programming. So what are the key features of agile process? So here we emphasize on adaptive planning rather than hardcore planning. So we plan, but we don't overcommit to the plan because the things are very dynamic. And also a lot of emphasis on collaboration of the team members and the team members with the customer side. And we make sure that our development is iterative. So that is where we can absorb new changes. We can provide early competitive advantage to the customer and also get early feedback. The agile process has a lot of emphasis in continuous improvement of the process. So that is why we are having retrospective meetings at the end of each iteration. So we discussed about the nature of software in the software development field. And then we discuss the challenges. And finally, we discuss some approaches, techniques that we use. The engineering approach, the project management, and the agile development. So I hope you got some good understanding about the overview of the software development process. So the end result is the high quality software with high productivity, and we can meet the deadlines and the budget, and also ultimately the customer get the business success, and the software developers are highly satisfied with working with sustainable pace, and they get a lot of challenges, opportunities to build their careers as well. So if you feel like this session is interesting and also useful, make sure you like it. Thank you.